Jesus, of course, is my king. He's your king. He is our king today. He's ruling and reigning, even though the world looks like things are really getting bad, people. But God and Jesus are still in control. The enemy only thinks he has control, and it looks like he does. In the natural sense, but spiritually speaking, he has nothing. He has nothing. He only has what we allow him to have. And we don't have to allow him to have anything in our natural bodies, because Jesus took all sin. Everybody's, yours and mine, past, present, and future, he took. And he took everybody's sickness, past, present, and future, on that cross that day. I mean, I'm telling you, people, Jesus did not look like a handsome-looking guy on that cross. I'm telling you. The movies portray Jesus as a, you know, glorious-looking, great-looking guy. But you know what? In the natural, he is the most precious and the beautiful one of all. He is. You know, I saw the outline of his face. It was black and white. I didn't get it in color. So, but, you know, it was the outline of his face that little boy and that little girl, she drew the painting, and he saw it. His face as he walked on the earth, that was his reflection on the earth. But when we see him in his glory, oh my goodness, that's going to be a day. What a day that's going to be when we really see him in all his glory. Right now we can't. The day that's going to be. I can't wait. And I know Jesus is coming soon. So I hope you're going to be ready. Oh, I hope you're going to be ready, because it's getting nearer. I know. And he's come for some today already, you know? You know, anyway, there's a man that he talks about every second there's people going to hell. They're going there. Are you one of those that's going to go to hell today? I hope not. Gosh, I pray not. But it is your choice. See, we all have a choice. But if you want to know the truth, you get in there and seek it for yourself. I had to do that. We've all had to do that want to know the truth. If you want to know the truth, you've got to seek to find it. And you got to ask and keep asking. You know, keep asking, keep seeking, and keep knocking. And it will be open for you. Don't give up. Don't ever give up, you know. Sure, flesh, you know, flips and flops around. Hey, my flesh flips and flops around, so I know yours does. But I'm not going to Egypt, which Egypt represents the world. I'm going to God first. And then if he says to do something and go down and see this person or that, then that's when we go. But otherwise, we should always ask God on everything. Hey, he created us. Don't you think he knows this body better than anyone? Well, I know he does. Better than doctors. And yes, he gave us doctors. I'm not putting doctors down. Doctors are great. You know, I had some beautiful physician that, you know, helped me, you know, when I had my operation on my breast, you know. So I know they are good out there, but they still cannot compare to God. God is still in control, even of that hand that is there operating on me. I mean, he's got to be there, you know. The dentist, when I had that operation on my mouth, you know. Hey, God was there. The dentist was there, and yes, but God was there doing his work, making sure everything got done right. Yeah, we got to remember those past things and what God's doing and what he's done already and what he's going to do in our lives, because that's the faith, the hope, the glory is all found in him. Amen. And when he gave me this song when I was 60 years old, now I'm 64, I just had a birthday this month on the 20th, and 7 days ago, actually. And so I'm 64 now, but 4 years ago, he gave me this song, and I got what I shared with you. Well, then I kept asking him. Gotta ask. Again, there we gotta ask, you know. So I kept asking God, and I said, well, God, if it's okay, I would like for you to give me some music, because I had this beautiful keyboard. Never really used it much, you know. I bought this from my sister. They were going out of town, and she wanted to sell it, and I got a good deal for it, so I bought it from her, And I got on it, and I do my little thing once in a while, you know, because I don't know the keyboard. Honestly, I don't know much about it. I know the C chords, and I know some chords and stuff like that. But as far as being able to play and understanding all that, I don't. But I know he does. And I know he can help me. And he has helped me all my life with stuff. Even the computer and this camera and all this stuff. Yes, he helped me to get the teaching, of course, from public access television. But you know what? He's making me better and better at it. He's improving me as I go. And isn't that what we want? We want to be improved as we go. He's the potter, we're the clay, right? Amen. Anyway, so I was asking him, and finally I sat down here, and this is what I got. And I thought, wow, sounds like I will praise you. I will praise you. I will praise you with my heart. I will praise you. I will praise you with my whole heart. I will praise you. So he gave me that. Isn't that exciting? I mean, I'm excited about it. I'm not perfect at it yet, but you know what? I'm on my way. And he says if I practice, I need to practice. Practice, practice, practice is what he told me. That's the Father, you know. Oh, and it's going to be for his glory, for his honor, and his praise is, oh, that's the only reason I want to do anything is for him. I want to be busy about our Father's business. Do you want to be busy about your Father's business today? I hope so. I pray so, because that's what we're to be doing. You know, the harvest is white, the laborers are few. So let's pray to the Father that he'll send more laborers, and I'm going to go. Are you going to go? Yes, let's all go. Let's all go that are believers, not in the flesh, people. We are to go in the spirit, and we are to move and live and have our being there. As Paul says, live and move and have your being in the spirit realm. It's in the spirit, and we pray in the spirit. And I'm telling you, if you pray in the spirit and you have faith and believe, you'll see it happen right in front of you. I've been doing that lately, and it's a wonderful thing. It's a wonderful thing for our Father to show us right in front of us, just like he did Jesus. It's for their glory. It's for their honor and their praise. It's nothing we can do. I can't do it, and you can't do it. But you know what? In God and Jesus, we can. We can do all things through Jesus Christ who strengthens us. You know, and I know some people hate that, but you know what? It's the truth. I can do all things through Jesus Christ who strengthens me. There's things that I would never be doing in the natural. There's no way I would have done a lot of things I'm doing today back then, because my flesh would have said no way. But you know what? My spirit man says, yes way. You can do all things through Jesus Christ who strengthens you. You can do all things. God will be there. I'm here to help you. The Holy Spirit tells me that. He is my teacher, and he does teach us things, you know, from the Bible. Even with this kind of thing, he will help us. But we have to be. Worship him in spirit and in truth. That's what it's all about today. Not in the flesh realm, people. We got to be more in the spirit. More in the spirit. Oh, worshiping our Father God and Jesus in spirit and in truth. And the only way we can do that is to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Don't just let him come upon you. Be filled with him today. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Amen.